Hello and welcome to Blue Chip Treasure. I am Tanushree Banerjee, editor of Equity Master's Safe Blue Chip Recommendation Service, Stock Select. The Sensex has gained over 10% in the past 30 days. But over the past week, sentiments in the stock markets have been a bit edgy. And that's primarily for two reasons. The resurgence in fresh COVID-19 cases in China and other countries that were believed to have recovered from the crisis. And one of the worst India-China border clashes since 1962. Now, apart from being careful about your portfolio in terms of asset allocation, quality of stocks, and staggered buying, there is something more that you need to do. And that is figuring out the best way to buy businesses that could benefit from these crises. I'm sure you've already heard or read about plenty of businesses that could benefit from the COVID-19 crisis. For instance, the potential in pharma stocks that I explained in one of my earlier videos. But there is yet another sector that has some solid yet deeply undervalued stocks. And the India-China standoff is a firm reminder of why these businesses deserve a lot more attention. Of course, I'm referring to India's defense stocks. Now, India's defense budget, despite being the third largest in the world, is nothing to write home about. For most of the defense spending is not really allocated to modernizing the defense equipment or for investments in new technology. At least that's not the case so far. And since the government does not have sufficient fiscal headroom to expand the defense budget exponentially, public-private partnerships and investments from the private sector are the only ways to secure funding for the sector. In fact, that's not the case only with India. Even the US government, which has the largest defense budget in the world, manufactures just a third of the defense requirements. The rest are done by private sector companies like Boeing, Lockheed Martin, General Dynamics, Northrop Grumman, BAE Systems. India has largely relied on imports for high-tech defense equipment so far. But importing defense equipment is neither cost-friendly nor a permanent solution for India. So it is important that the Make in India mega trend in the defense sector takes off to cater to this demand. And why just domestic demand? India also exports some defense equipments to countries like Italy, Maldives, Nepal, Bhutan, Mauritius, Sri Lanka, Israel, Egypt and UAE. So the Make in India effort could substantially boost India's defense exports. In fact, the government has already budgeted for nearly 75% growth in defense exports this year. But of course, a lot would depend on the MNC and private sector investments in the sector. Keeping this in mind, the government recently introduced some reforms for the defense sector. They include increasing the foreign direct investment, that is FDI, in the defense sector from 49% to 74%. It opened up the space sector to private players. Rationalization of airspace over India, and the corporatization of the ordnance factory boards. Nevertheless, the revenue visibility of players in the sector would depend on fresh orders and capacity utilization. So what kind of defense businesses am I talking about, and how much upside could the stocks have? Well, there is Hindustan Aeronautics that designs, manufactures and assembles aircrafts, helicopters and jet engines for the Air Force. There's Bharat Electronics, which supplies communication equipment such as radars. There's Bharat Forge, which supplies artillery guns to the Indian military. L&T designs and manufactures arms, armaments and even submarines. Ashok Leyland is one of the top suppliers of armed vehicles to the military. BEML supplies ground support equipment. Bharat Dynamics supplies missiles, torpedoes and allied defense equipment. Rolta India is a provider of geospatial solutions. Cochin Shipyard offers shipbuilding and maintenance services to the Indian Navy. And Astra Microwave supplies microwave-based high-value radio frequency components. About the upside in these stocks, well, that would depend on their earnings and valuation re-rating. But if we were to compare the market cap of the top defense manufacturer in India with the top 5 globally, this is how it would look. the market cap of India's largest defense company would be a tiny dot compared to the top 5 companies globally. This suggests that the companies have huge room for growth both in earnings and valuations. But you cannot be buying any and every business that claims to be supplying something to the Ministry of Defense. Rather, you should be looking for businesses, be it PSU or private sector, which have a clear focus on defense and are already fetching significant portion of revenues from it or are likely to get there in few years. Which means the businesses, apart from being defense focused, have to also be ones with lean balance sheet, have technology tie-ups, preferably with MNC defense majors. They should be scalable with minimum capex and, more importantly, not overpriced. By following these attributes, you will have defense stocks in your portfolio that are almost bulletproof. Want to know more about the defense stocks I'm recommending to StockSlip subscribers? Make sure you read about them in Equity Master's free newsletter, The Profit Hunter. And do share your thoughts on defense sector stocks in the comment section of this video. Take care. Thank you.